What was the mood among the scientists on this historic occasion? Surprisingly subdued. Even a celebratory bottle of wine did not lift their spirits as they contemplated how the world would never be the same. Manhattan Project veterans Leona Marshall-Libby and Crawford Greenewalt reflect on the moments after the Chicago Pile 1 went critical for the first time.
Somewhat later, after the control rods were all put to bed and the charts were pulled out and clipped off and so on, Gene Wigner showed up with a famous little flask of Chianti. He poured it into paper cups. Everyone drank it very quietly. There was no toast, nothing, no remarks. Very dramatic, really. The most effective kind of drama, probably, at that point.
I remember very well Wigner reaching under a desk and pulling out a bottle of Chianti in a brown paper bag and handing it to Fermi with a bow. Well, here again, no great excitement, no cheers, satisfaction that the experiment had worked. And I think that was really the feeling that I had in my mind. Well, thank God that one's over.
Leo Szilard biographer William Lanouette describes Szilard's reaction.
Szilard and Fermi found themselves standing together on the balcony that overlooked the squash court. And at that point, Szilard turned and shook Fermi's hand and congratulated him and then announced, "This day will go down as a black day in the history of mankind."